Oh my gosh, let's try this again. Hello, everybody. If you were on for like the 2 seconds I was on, my camera flipped off and flew onto the ground and then cut off. That hasn't happened in a very long time. Hello, everybody. Okay, my iPad is dead. It's across the room. I'm having all kinds of issues getting back on track today. Well, I can't see it. Okay, you know what? Let's grab this and see if we can get it together. Hi, Sandy. Whoo, I hope the rest of the day doesn't go like that. I'm already sweating. Okay, you guys, look. Doesn't it look weird? Crazy. Before I left for my trip, I did some packing, as you can see. And I guess I've gotten used to it when I walk in. I don't notice, but on the video, it looks very strange. Very strange. All right, let me see if I can pull you guys up. If you weren't here at the very beginning, you missed it. My camera went flying. Okay, hold on. Let's see if I can get it pulled up. All right, all right. Yeah, so I'm in the midst of packing, getting back on track from being gone. Jet lag is real. Today I'm feeling better. Every night about like 8 o'clock, I'm like, well, I have to go to sleep. But for the most part, it does look naked, doesn't it, Rhonda? I know, it's very strange. Anyways, I am back in the office. I've gotten all caught up for the most part. Had like 1,000 emails, still trying to sift through those. But if you placed an order while I was gone, your boxes shipped out this morning. Paper and ribbon shares have all shipped out. Let's see, what else did I work on? I can't remember. Facebook Friday is today because it's a short week. I'm leaving tomorrow. And look, I still have some BOGO mystery boxes right here. Okay, so if you spend $125, you can get a medium box for free. If you spend $150, you can get a large box for free. So there's two different host codes right now. I sent out an email today about these that has the host code for that. I'm going to do Facebook Friday too. So you can decide which you want. Do you want the Facebook Friday projects or do you want the mystery boxes? Use whichever host code or email me and let me know. There's a lot going on the next 3 weeks. Just expect chaos from here. The house is looking good. They poured the driveway yesterday, which always feels like, right? That's like one of the very last things they do. But there's still a lot to do, and it looks like maybe our closing will probably be pushed to the last week of June rather than the third week of June. So who knows? Everything is just tentative right now, so we'll see. But this week, I had these projects planned before I left. We're going to use the carousel horses. I'm going to flip you guys around and show you some things before we get started on that. Let's see if I can do this without dropping my phone again. All right, and I do want to zoom in just a bit before I put you guys on here. Our Norway trip was awesome. It was stunningly beautiful. One of the ports, and it was the port that I was really looking the most forward to because we had rented these tiny cars to drive up into the mountains in with the guys, and we were all, Rhonda and Ange and I were super excited to see our giant husbands cram into these cars. But that day we pulled into the port and it was too windy. They couldn't get the bridge and the tender to work. So we pulled in, got to see it, and didn't get off the boat. So that was a little bit disappointing. But other than that, the other ports were beautiful and fun, and it was so good to be back with friends. I haven't seen my friend Ange McKay in 4 years. Well, okay, I take that back. We saw each other in the airport 2 years ago, just, or maybe no, it was last summer, just randomly. We were both at the Seattle airport at the same time. But we haven't been on a trip together in 4 years because of the pandemic. So it was wonderful. It was much needed. It was like no time had passed. It was fun. I will say the North Sea is wild. There was one night I felt like I had to hold on to the sheets, otherwise I was going to roll out of the bed. It was crazy. But it was fun. It was fun. But I'm glad to be back in the warmth. And we're headed to the beach tomorrow, so that's why we're doing this today. Okay, Judy said, did they finally get your table right? Yes, in my new studio, they finally got my center island correct. It was crazy, but yes, now it is in place, and I counted yesterday. It's big enough, I think, that I can sort 113 packets on that one center island, which is awesome. My mom was laughing at me because I had already counted it out, but that's really important for me, and I need that space, so I was excited about it. Thank you for asking. Okay, let me just run through some things. So today we've got a starter kit promotion. The starter kit is always $99, but right now you get more than you normally get in your starter kit. You get $155 in product in your starter kit. And it can be anything you want from the annual catalog, from the online exclusives, from the clearance rack. You can build your own kit however you want it. And then you are a demonstrator after that, and you can be any kind of demonstrator you want to. Don't let that scare you. You don't have to do what I do. You can be your own customer, your one and only customer. We call those happy shoppers. You get the starter kit, and then you're part of my team. You get your discount, or if you sell to a few friends, you get that instant income from them, from their orders. And then you get early access to the catalogs, you get to order early, you can attend Stampin' Up! Events, you get to be part of my team, which is, of course, awesome. That means you'll get all my PDFs for free. Every time I release a PDF, my team gets it for free, and you get discounted class kits from me. So if that's something that you're interested in, when you click on today's post, which, you know what? I bet it's not up because I didn't schedule it. Let me go do that right now. If you go to pinkbugroo.com and you give me like 3 seconds. Hold on. Let me get it. Let me make sure it has the right things here. Replace image. You know, it's been a crazy day. Had a hard time tying all these loose ends up. Okay, let's try it now. All right. So if you go to pinkbugroo.com and you scroll down, you'll see a photo that looks like this. You can click on it, or at the top, there's a join tab, and that'll take you to that page that gives you all the details. Yeah, okay, everything is up. Today's blog post is up. Okay, good. So that's the starter kit special. You have all month to decide on that. One thing I wanted to let you know, too, if you're deciding to get the starter kit, Stampin' Up! Is releasing some online exclusives in July, July 6th, I believe. They're not available to order right now unless you are a demonstrator. And I will just show you, give you a little sneak peek. They're Christmassy things. This isn't all that's going to be released in July, but this is some of it. The reason I mention it now is because if you're going to get the starter kit, you can choose these things for your starter kit as well. That's part of the perk of being a demonstrator, is you get early access. So they always kind of rope that into the starter kit. You'll have early access to add those things to your starter kit if you're interested. Otherwise, you guys are gonna have to wait till July. It'll be Christmas in July when this stuff comes out. Not all of it's Christmas. There's a beautiful little flower set down here too. And there'll be other things that we haven't seen. There's like a little sneak peek that I've seen. It's not on this flyer, but there's a sneak peek maybe on the image. I don't know if I shared that image or not, but it has a punch. It's a truck, like a little truck, old-timey truck, and a punch. Very cute. So be on the lookout for that July 6th. We demonstrators can't order that yet. That was just a little sneak peek I saw in a photo. Okay, let me navigate back to where you guys are so I can see what you're saying. There we go. Okay. Also, right now, and this is also applicable to the starter kit, we're having a designer series paper sale, 15% off select papers, and it's most of our DSP. So if you are a paper addict like I am, this is a good time to stock up on those papers. It's most of, you know, and I would pull my iPad over, but it's stuck to the wall in a plug that's too short to bring over here. But if you click on the link on today's blog post or on today's PDF, it'll take you over there. And I think if you just go to stampinup.com, there's an icon right at the beginning that shows you. You can click on it. It'll show you all the papers that are on sale. Okay, before we get to this, we have a brand new All-Star Tutorial PDF. This month's is fresh as a daisy. This is the last month in our six-month series. We'll start again in July with a few new demonstrators in the group. I will, of course, continue and offer that as a subscription next month. But right now, this PDF is free if you put in an online order over $50, or you can buy it in my PDF store for $15. My project this month is a gift box, and I actually ordered, let me show you guys. I ordered some bracelets. Alex and Ani was having an online sale, and I ordered these to go in this box. I'm gonna give these as gifts. They had daisies and little sunflowers. So this box, the tutorial for this box is in the PDF. All right, so again, there's details about that on my blog today, as well as the second page of today's PDF. You can click on that, and there's the details for those things too. This video, PDF is, it includes 12 project tutorials, and they're all video tutorials. The PDF has the measurements and the supply list and links for each project. So that's that. It's brand new, hot off the presses. I just printed it out. Last but not least, you guys, I have a bunch of paper pumpkins, all the little things, 10 years of growth. I have one Hope box from August 2021, and I have a few from this month too. So if you need a paper pumpkin, please let me know. I have a lot. They're all $26 shipped, except for this one, the 10 years of growth. I've got a lot of extras, so I'm going to sell this one for $20 shipped. It's a little bit of a discount. I don't want to move them, you guys. Please help me clear out some of these extra things I have. So if you're interested in any of these paper pumpkin kits, send me an email, please. That'll be the best way to grab those. And I think that is it. Okay. Oh, no. I've got to tell you about Club Create. This is when's the 7th? Next Wednesday. All right. So you've got until next Wednesday to subscribe to this month's Club Create. It features the Zany Zoo. I've actually already started working on it. I've already done all the die cutting and the scoring for it. So I have some spots left. If you want to subscribe to Club Create, it's $39 and it'll include 5 projects and about $20 in product. It also includes shipping, the PDF, and the video. This image right here, if you click on that, there'll be a subscription link there for you. So I'm watching this on my iPad and it's looking pretty glitchy. I don't know why that is. I'm the only one home today. Nobody else is using the internet. So, sorry. If that's happening on your end too, I'm sorry. I don't have control over the internet. As much as I would like to have control of the internet, I do not. If it's too glitchy for you, come back. It always fixes that at the end when I upload it. So, yeah, I know I'm still zoomed in. I did that on purpose because I'm going to do a lot of coloring today. I need to be a little bit zoomed in for that. Okay, so that is that. Let's look at prizes. I have 2 winners from the last time, which was about 3 weeks ago. Karen Bull and Sandy Perry, thanks for sharing my video. I'm going to send you guys both a stamp set, the go-to greetings. I know I have your mailing address, Sandy. Karen, I think I have yours. If it's changed, please message me. Let me know. You guys, if you ever move, please let me know, because once I put your address in my stamps.com account, it's there, and I just pull it up. I don't always go back and check it against the Stampin' Up! Website. So if you ever move, please let me know, because that would be helpful. All right, this week I've got the Let's Go Shopping bundle. This bundle is so cute. I'll be giving this away to one person who shares the video next week. All right, so all you have to do is share either on Facebook or YouTube. Let me know in the comments that you shared and I will choose one person as the winner next week. All right. So hopefully you've gone to pinkbuckaroo.com. You've gotten your free PDF already. This is my free with a purchase class that I do every week. You can get the projects for free with an online order of $35 or more. Here's the host code. I've zoomed in so much that you can't see it, but it's right here as well on the PDF, and it's over on my blog post too. I send the make and takes. Here are some old ones, and they come like this. I don't do any stamping. You have to do all the stamping yourself. If you don't have the stamp set that I use, you can either order it or you can use something else in its place. You also need the dies. So I will die cut things for you like circles. It looks like maybe that's all I'm die cutting. Oh, a tag and a circle this week. But all of these things, you'll need both the stamps and the dies to complete your projects. Okay, I think that is it. Let's get started. Let me see. Let me clear a little bit of space. Since I'm not going to use this iPad, I think I'm just going to get it out of the way. Move it over here. Move my computer over here. We're using some beautiful colors today. Look at the blends that I have set out. I'm loving Bubble Bath. And this is Azure Afternoon. You know what? I'm just going to go with that pronunciation. And, you know, if you say it differently, okay. I don't want to hear about it if I'm saying it wrong. Azure Afternoon. This card is the card that I created for my swap for my Norway incentive trip with the rest of the achievers who earned the trip. So I made 26 of these, and I love the colors, and I thought it would be fun for us today to make this card. So that's the first thing we're going to make. We're going to do our stamping, and my ink pad is gone. So let's get an ink pad. We're going to start by just stamping the horse in Memento Black. All right. And the reason I chose Memento Black is because we're using Stamp and Blend. So you've got to use a water-based ink when you're using an alcohol marker. Now we're going to use this sentiment right here that says enjoy the ride, but we're just going to do the enjoy part. I wanted a short sentiment for this card. And so you can tape it off, you can mask it, or you can just go like this, because see how I can see exactly where I'm inking. And I'm going to put that right there. Now we're going to stamp the pole that goes on this cute little carousel. I'm going to stamp it onto a basic white tailor-made tag. And it's a little bit too long, and that's okay. We're just going to let it hang off the end. Carla says, I feel like my bubble bath looks purplish. Yes. So I have found, and you'll see in a little while, that fresh freesia and bubble bath are very similar. I'm going to use them in another project. The third project, I'll show you. And yes, I sometimes even have trouble when I'm coloring using the two, telling them apart without, you know, without looking. They are very similar. All right, so let's start with our horses, our carousel horses' hair. I went to Pinterest, as always, and typed in carousel horses to see, I mean, we've all ridden a carousel horse at some point, surely, right? But I couldn't think of, like, okay, what colors should it be? And guess what? Every color you can think of is correct. They are in every color. Most of them are kind of sparkly and pastel. They have kind of light colors, some rainbow, a lot of rainbow-ish. One thing, if you're looking for inspiration, that I like to do is to type in carousel horses cookies or cakes, and you'll see handmade cookies and cakes that people have made, and they're always so beautiful, and they have great color combinations. So a lot of times, that's where I get my color ideas from, cookies and cakes. All right, so I just did Smoky Slate, and I'm going to take Azure Afternoon Light, and we're going to color in this saddle. Today's the last day of school for my girls, last day of sophomore year for Emma, and last day of eighth grade for Addie, which means we are done with middle school, on to high school. This is my last baby, and now I only have high schoolers, which is crazy to me. It goes by just way too fast. Ellie is done with her sophomore year of college. She's been done for a couple of weeks. So I've got two high schoolers now and a college kid. All right, Flirty Flamingo Dark. We'll do that on her little decorations here. I originally did this in Coastal Cabana, but then I realized I needed an ink to match, a ribbon to match, and we have this new beautiful Azure Afternoon ribbon, so I changed it to Azure Afternoon rather than Coastal Cabana. If you have Coastal Cabana or Flirty Flamingo ribbon, then you could change it, of course, if you wanted to. Oh, I forgot part of her hair. I'm taking Wink of Stella and just adding Wink of Stella to the white parts of the horse. I am going to add Wink of Stella to every horse that we color today. All right, come back with Azure Afternoon. I think I'm going to do light. Sometimes blends are pretty dark, and this is one of them. The light is pretty dark. And these little segments are very small, so just kind of tap the color in. Tap, tap, tap. Like that. Norway was exactly how you imagine. Lush and green, mountainous. Very European. The cities were super clean. You know how when you're in a port, it's kind of stinky, kind of dirty? Well, Norway's port was not like that at all. It was tidy and quaint and cute, all of them. It just was such a cute country. We didn't get off one port. We weren't able to get off the boat, which feels really very, I felt trapped that day, even though we were getting off the ship the next day and we had gotten off the day before. Just knowing that they've told you, no, you can't get off, felt very, I don't know. Like I felt trapped, kind of mad. I mean, kind of mad. I was mad. And we booked our excursion outside of the cruise line, which means we did not get a refund. So I'm still working on that, but I think that we're pretty much out of luck. This dye right here are the new Nested Essential dyes. I love these dyes. I've been using them almost on every project. I used Post-it tape on this horse. I'm just finding lately I'm struggling keeping my dyes in the right place. So Post-it tape to the rescue. I have linked it today. Oh, and I did that the wrong direction. Okay, well, we'll fix that. We need the flag to fly this way. You know what? Let's just cut another one and we'll stamp it. Anyways, I am, for whatever reason, just really struggling keeping my dies in place around my stamped images lately. So I've just been using Post-it tape a lot. All right, so we'll fix that. Let's move that out of the way. And we'll take this flag. And we will stamp this again. Like that. Enjoy. I wanted a small sentiment for this card. I felt like all the ones that we had were just too big, so I created a shortened sentiment. All right, now you're going to need a piece of basic white that is 3 3/4 by... No, what's going on here? This should be brand new. Let's see if I can fix it. You need four. Sometimes you can fix it, but I don't know. We'll see about this one. It's doubled up on itself. This hardly ever happens with these new. You know what? Let's see. Maybe. They say you can fix them, unlike the old. Let's see if that worked. Okay, it did not. All right, let me grab another one. Hold on. I'm going to have to play with that. They say you can fix your stamp and seal, but I don't think I've ever had to do that. These are 3 3/4 by 4. I always make them a little bit longer, you know, so that I can trim them off on the ends to make them perfectly even. And I'm just going to kind of space them about half an inch apart. You can use your grid paper to line these up if you don't feel like you can get it right. Put your grid paper underneath there and just line them up on either side. All right, these are Flirty Flamingo strips. And we'll just trim them off like that. Now we need dimensionals. And we're going to put our horse on the carousel pole. And then we're going to put the tag on the stripes. You know, Joanne, I've heard other people say that, and I don't ever have problems with a Stamp and Seal. Now, Stamp and Seal Plus, I have a hard time with that because I'm so heavy-handed. That's why I just use Stamp and Seal. Every now and then, it does that, but it always seems to correct itself. I think it's just a whatever way you know, everybody holds it a little bit different. Because I hear some people swear by Stamp and Seal Plus. Then I hear some people swear by Stamp and Seal. Some people want something else. You know, it's just a matter of trial and error, I think. I will say Stamp and Seal adhesive is very strong. I feel pretty confident in using it, even for 3D projects. It feels, you know, we used to have Snail, and that was not strong enough for 3D projects, but I feel like Stamp and Seal does the job. Okay, so there's that Azure Afternoon bow. Yeah, it is tricky, Carla. Like, I want to use it, but I when I am using adhesive, it's like a muscle memory for me, and I never am thinking of what I'm doing. And with that, I have to stop and think about it, which I don't end up doing, which then messes up. So I'm like, let's just stick with what works for us. I'm going to take these cute little flowers and stamp them 3 times in Flirty Flamingo. You know, we did the swap on the ship. You hand in your bag of cards and they sort them out for you, and then you get your bag back. And I was really hoping there would be a lot of new catalog stuff, but it was mostly the stuff you've already seen. The balloons, it was all the pre-order stuff that we could order early. The balloons, the lots of daisy stuff, several monkeys, and I think maybe one fishing card, and that was it. I was really hoping for some variety so I could show you guys, but I don't know. It was just kind of the stuff I've already seen. I was hoping for more of these, and I didn't see one single swap card using the carousel. So hopefully you guys will get some ideas today, because I don't think there are very many out there. All right, so there is my swap card, and the sentiment, enjoy. I mean, that could be for anything, right? Birthday, baby shower, good luck, I don't know, thinking of you, gift card, whatever. Teacher gift at the end of the year, whatever. Enjoy is pretty generic. Okay, so there's our first card. Let me move this out of the way. Next week, I have Hey Chuck planned for us. You know, the rooster, the funky little rooster stamp set. That'll be real cute. Yeah, Karen, I mean, I think I might have seen one, maybe two on Pinterest. There were not a lot, especially when I was trying to plan my swap card, there was nothing. So it was all what just came out of my mind. All right, now this card, this bundle, I mean, has these really cool dies, okay? So you can make your own little carousel. So we're going to use these to make the whole little carousel. You're going to need this one and this one. This is the base right here. And then we're going to cut out the smaller horses. All right. Now I'm going to show you guys something that I feel like, you know, where is, I'm going to use a Stamparatus. Hold on. I got to find it first. I had it out and I don't know where it went. Hopefully I didn't leave the stamp on it. It was sitting right here. Let's see. Nope, here. Nope, it is gone. Okay. You guys, you remember the last Facebook? Oh, here it is. Okay. Remember the last, oh, it's over there. I got it. Remember the last Facebook Live when I dropped the die? I can't remember what it was. I dropped the die on the floor. I never found it. After Facebook Live that day, I searched and searched and searched, and I could not find it. How, and it's so frustrating. How does that happen? How does that even happen? I don't know. So it's gone. Maybe when I move, maybe we'll find it. I don't know. So weird. The lemons, that's what it was. The tiny lemons. You guys have good memory. Yeah, and that's kind of one you need. I don't know. You know, this table that I'm working on has a ledge underneath that I keep a lot of baskets stacked up and my paper trimmer and all that. So maybe it's like wedged in there somewhere, but I heard it hit the ground. I'm thinking it also could have slid underneath the countertops or the cabinets because there's like this tiny little space. I don't know. It was a real bummer. Okay. Am I going to use? No. You know what? I'm not going to use the Stamparatus for this. If you have the Stamparatus, it's going to help you tremendously. These two stamps do the hair, the mane and the tail. And I could not get them lined up without the Stamparatus. This is the saddle. And I'm going to attempt to stamp it in Berry Burst. It's a little bit easier than the, I have to like hold my breath. It's a little bit easier than the, okay, not terrible bad, not terribly bad. It's a little bit easier than the tail and mane. I could not for the life of me get those lined up. So I was like, you know what? That's why we have Stampin' Blends. We will color their hair with Stampin' Blends. All right, so we're gonna use, Bubble Bath. Here is what Carla was talking about. Look at Bubble Bath with Fresh Freesia. Look how close they are. They're like in the color spectrum, real close to each other. They're definitely different, but this one definitely has purple undertones, and this has, I feel like, some pink in it for sure. All right, so we'll just color these little horsey tails in with Bubble Bath Dark. Okay, and then we'll add some sparkle. You know what? I have to sit down. You found it in the dog bed, Lisa. Okay, you know, that's the thing. You hear it, but then, you know, that's probably just the first time it hit the floor, right? So it could bounce. One time, I know for sure I lost a die. Remember the bicycle that had all the cute little things that you could put on it, like in the basket. I lost one of those dies underneath. It fell back behind my cabinets and it's on the floor somewhere back there and I could not get it. I could not get it. We may take these cabinets out of here and put them in my husband's man cave in the new house. So maybe I'll find all kinds of missing things when we take the cabinets down. All right, so I'm using fresh freesia with bubble bath. They coordinate really, really well. I'm going to put these little stripes on the poles like that. And then we'll add... You found it in your scrap, but you know, I threw my scrapbook with all the folders to weed those out of the real red folders, so don't lose hope. Yeah. If it falls into like the recycle bin, which I have right next to my table, it's a goner. I mean, I think I have lost dyes that way. Angela says it happened to me with one of my dyes. A little, and when we moved, I actually found the dye and put it in an empty stamp case with a note on what it was. That's really smart. Had actually packed the dye set. Yeah. Oh, I hope I'm as lucky as y'all. Because, especially when I pack my stuff up for my BOGO sale, I hate when I have to put a note on dyes. Missing one or missing two. Because nobody wants a dye set that's missing dyes. Okay, now, and we're going to use this new, it's called Subtle Shimmer, I believe, Berry Burst and Bubble Bath. This, you know, our glimmer paper that had like the glitter that kind of like would come off and stuff. This stuff is so soft, and I really like it. We have several new kind of specialty papers. This one is just really, really good. It has 5 different colors in it. We're going to use both of these. We'll cut the Berry Burst first. And, whoa, almost dropped it. And then we're going to cut the top part from this gold foil. And from the Bubble Bath Shimmer, we only need these two little segments. So we'll just cut out the top of that. So see this die, it has that top and it has the bottom. All right, so let's take that off and take that off. And then we'll get this. The piece is way too big, so I'm just gonna, let's turn this over because it's starting to warp a little bit. We'll put, yeah, I'm trying to make room for my horses, which are right here. All right. Now, a little trick for these is, well, one thing is that they look identical and they are not. So if you put your die down and you're like, what? This doesn't work. We'll just try the other horse because they are not identical. One is looking up and one is looking down. And their legs are a little bit different. So you want to like look up here, look here, 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 and here, like all the points to make sure you have it lined up right. Okay, and then we're going to run this through. And we've got our little horses. And then for this, all we need are these little pieces right here. Okay. You could cut 2 full ones out and then make 2 different cards. One, you know, one that uses the little pieces of the Berry Burst and one that uses the little pieces of the Bubble Bath and then switch. All right. Now, I have a piece of, somewhere over here, basic white, and we're going to use our liquid glue. And we're going to start, we're going to build from the bottom up. Got our gold foil base, and then we've got our Berry Burst Shimmer platform base, I don't know. Okay, and then we've got our big piece. You could put adhesive sheets on the back if you want. That would probably be easier. All right, and now we'll take our pieces and put them right here like that. And let's take dimensionals. And we'll put one here. You want the base, the pole, to be touching just the edge of that base. Otherwise, it's like floating in air. What was the movie where the carousel horses, with Mary Poppins, wasn't it? Where they like floated off. And then this guy will go right here, although we need him to not be hanging off too much on that side. Thanks, Pam. Total sleeper. You know, it was one of the first ones that jumped out at me. And I will tell you that when I started, when I pulled it out, it was a little intimidating at first. It took me a while to kind of like get in the groove. And then once I started, I couldn't stop. I've got 5 projects for you guys. So cute. All right, now this is actually Sweet Sorbet Metallic Ribbon, which, in my opinion, doesn't match the Sweet Sorbet cardstock very well because it's metallic, so it kind of has a different color, but it matches this really well. This is Berry Burst, and it matches really well. Glue dots, have I used them? Yes, here they are. And then I found an embellishment that goes on here perfectly too. So we'll put that up there. And then, so if you look closely at this, you'll see these little ovals right here. I don't know, can you guys see the little ovals? So we've got these cute little ovals right here. They're called opaque ovals. So I'm just going to put one there, and one there. And they're the perfect color. They're bubble bath. How cute. It looks like a real carousel, right? All right. So now you'll notice there's no sentiment on the front of this card. This is one of those cards that was just too busy to have the sentiment on the front. So we're going to put it on the inside. This paper is the Something Eclectic. It's called Something Eclectic. And we're going to stamp those same little flowers. Like that, around the edge. And I've got a Berry Burst card base. And we'll get dimensionals again. Thanks, Ashley. I was pretty excited when I was like, they're perfect. Those ovals, they're perfect. They like fit perfectly. There we go. And we're going to put that right in the middle. Now, we're not going to leave the sentiment off. Inside, we're going to stamp this. Now, guess what I'm using? Wild wheat. I told you guys, I didn't know if I could get on board with wild wheat, but guess what? Wild wheat looks like gold. When you ink it up, it's very gold-like. So, it goes really well here with these gold elements. My downline, Deanna, I have to give her credit for that. She brought a card to one of our team meetings. She was ready to defend wild wheat, and she did a great job. She said, look, it looks like gold. And I was like, okay, you know what? It does. So don't count wild wheat out. It's a great gold, which makes me think that we're going to use it quite a bit in the fall. Quite a bit. There's a die for this banner in the set as well, but you don't always have to use the die. You can just stamp it however you want. And there you go. What do you guys think? That one is a little more complicated, but not terribly difficult. And it's got a lot of shimmer and glimmer. All right, and let's celebrate. Again, kind of a generic sentiment, if I do say so. You could use that for lots of things. Okay, one more. Now, while I was brainstorming, trying to decide on projects, you know, I always am trying to come up with a 3D, and I kept thinking of cotton candy, right? If you're somewhere where there's a carousel, I always think of Disney World or the zoo. Our zoo has a carousel. Then there's usually cotton candy around. So then I remembered that Pop Rocks has a cotton candy flavor. So we're going to make a little pouch to hold our cotton candy Pop Rocks. You guys, I saw the cutest video online the other day. You know how Facebook and Instagram just like put videos up for you. They're like, we think you would like this. It was a baby, or like a toddler, you know, like maybe 18 months old, trying Pop Rocks. And it was the funniest thing. I wish I knew. I mean, I guess if you Googled it, it would come up, but it was so funny. If you've never eaten Pop Rocks, surely, have you guys, is there anybody who hasn't tried Pop Rocks? They fizzle and you can feel them back by your ears. You know, that like sizzling back by your ears. When I was a kid, we thought they were the coolest thing. All right, let's make our pouch first. Now, I have individual recordings of these projects over on PayPal, on YouTube for you guys. And yesterday when I did this one, I realized my measurements were wrong. So it needs to be 4x10. Not 4x11. The PDF is corrected already, hopefully, because that would mean that would be 3 weeks in a row that I got measurements incorrect. You need a 4x10 piece of, what is this, bubble bath, and we're going to score it at 1 5¾. All right, and so then it's going to fold up like that and over like that. We are going to cut the edge. We'll go ahead and do that. It comes with this die set, has a scalloped edge. Did you see that video, Karen? It was so cute. You've never had them. You should try them. There's nothing else like them. It's very difficult to even describe it. It's like a sizzle. Back behind your ears. You know, like when something is sour where you can feel it back there and you kind of squint? It's kind of the same thing. All right, so on the lip of this, you're going to want to line this up on the edge, straight edge on the outside. And we're going to run this through. You really need post-it tape because you'll never keep it straight on here otherwise. All right, peel that off, and then it's going to just fold over like that. I'm going to take my liquid glue and put a very thin bead of glue on the edge like that, and we're going to set that down to dry. What can I put on top of it? I'll put this on top of it over here. All right, now while that's drying, we will do our stamping, and I am going to use a stamparatus for this one. We're going to stamp our horse and our pole in Memento Black. All right, and then I'm going to get this and put it on here. Yes, I know the stamparatus is not available anymore, but sometimes you just need to use it. Hopefully you got yours before it was gone. I'm going to line this up right here. I don't know if I'll ever not use my Stamparatus. I really try not to use anything. I really try not to use anything that's not current, but sometimes, every now and then, you just gotta do it. Okay, this this photopolymer is sticking to my fingers. Let's see if I can get it. It's like surgery. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Stay. There we go. All right. Let's pick that up. We are going to stamp it in Pool Party. And I'm going to do it twice so that it's pretty dark. Okay. All right. Now we'll use Fresh Freesia for her mane and her tail. Speaking of Disney World, they announced where the 2025 Stampin' Up! Incentive trip is going to be while we were in Norway, and it is Disney World. I'm not sure how I feel about it. I like Disney World, but you know, Disney World is not a relaxing vacation. Of course, I'll go and I'll absolutely love it if I am blessed enough to earn it again. You know, I always say we've taken the girls to Disney a few times, and you need a vacation after you get home from Disney World. It is exhausting, but at least I won't be jet lagged. Oh, jet lag. Oh, I don't do well with that transition back. I do not do well with that. All right, I'm going to take my light. Is this light? Nope, this is dark. I'm going to take my light Pool Party and color in. And you can even color this in a little bit too. Make it a little more solid. And then we'll get Wink of Stella. And I think this time, instead of doing the white part, I'll do the colored part. Wink of Stella will pick up your ink. So if you go over your ink and then you're going to go over something else next to it, make sure you just run it off like that first. All right, and then we'll hop back over to Bubble Bath for the pole. Let me see. You know, Karen, she says, I think Stampin' Up! Should give you permission. You know, we don't really have to get permission, you know? It just is a matter of, if somebody wants it and then I have to tell them it's not available anymore, I feel bad. You know, I will tell you that I have left feedback saying that we need the Stamparatus or something like it, because there's a lot of stamps that do that two-step stamping, and yeah, you can kind of fuddle your way through it without it, but you're so much more successful with that kind of stamping if you have Stamparatus. And it does other things too. Background stamps, that step stamping. But I get it. I get it. You know, it was a business decision they had to make, unfortunately. All right, we're going to actually cut this banner out this time with the die. I'm going to emboss it with white embossing powder. And you can see this circle sitting here is our new holographic paper. If you've looked in the catalog, you've seen probably the whole suite that is the outer space. I'm gonna have to unplug something to plug this in. So, and this is the holographic paper that is in that suite. It has three different types of holographic paper. I don't want to say patterns because they're not patterns and they're not shades. So I would say three different types of holographic paper. Really, really cool. Something we've never had before. And at first I was kind of like, I don't know what to do with this. But then when I was working on this, I thought, oh my gosh, the holographic paper would be so fun. It's whimsical and kind of, you know, goes well. You know, when you're on a carousel, there's usually like a mirror on the around part that you know, when you go around. So I thought that will go perfectly. All right, so we're gonna cut this out with its matching die right here. Let's see, my paper is warped because it got hot. So I probably need some tape for that too. Let's just run that through real quick. And then we'll run the other one. Lisa, I have had the other one. And it just seems very basic to me compared to the Stamparatus. You know, I mean, everybody has their own opinion and that's totally fine. But to me, it felt like two totally different things, for sure. Okay. Now, I need a piece of tape. I've run out of all my little pieces that I had on the edge of my table. I'm almost out of Post-it tape. Gonna have to order some more. All right, there's our little pole and our cute little horse. And now we're gonna put it all together with dimensionals. Karen, I 100% agree with that. The removable plates made it something completely different, but apparently there were people who didn't agree with that. So we all get to suffer because of it. First world problems, right? Oh, well. All right. Now we're going to put, hello, why can't I get that off? We're going to put this like that. Now let's bring back our pouch. And I have cut a piece of bubble bath DSP 3x4. And we'll put that right in the middle. Any of the patterns will work for this. Take our Pop Rocks and just slide them in. Okay, and then this folds over, and I'm gonna use my lemon lime twist. And we'll hold it closed like that with a ribbon. Ah, I wasted too much ribbon on the end. I have to cut off a big chunk. Scissors. All right, let's put on our little horse, and I'm going to put my dimensionals right there on the ribbon so that it'll hold it in place. And we'll put that kind of like that. And there you go. Super easy. That would make a fun party favor. Or again, like I always like to suggest, make up some birthday treats to keep in your desk at work or in a drawer at home. And when it's somebody's birthday, you can just whip it out and say, look what I made for you for your birthday. Okay, so there are our three projects. Let's look at them. Let's see if I can zoom out. We've got these, and we've got this card, and then this card. And if you would like these, the make and takes for these for free, I will be happy to send them to you as a thank you for a minimum $35 order. Using the host code, which is, where did I lose that paper? Which is right here. It's also on today's blog post. And the cutoff for these is Monday at midnight. I will cut them on Tuesday and ship them on Wednesday. I don't make you wait long for your make and takes. I try to get them out within the week so that the ideas are still fresh in your mind. And then you can always come back to YouTube or Facebook and watch the tutorials. Now I have two other projects for you. And I think they are actually my favorite of the five. This one I just made late. Well, actually, I made it yesterday morning for yesterday's blog post. Usually I'm way ahead, but I was not this week. Look, that's wild wheat, and it looks like gold. Add some shimmer to it, and you've got gold. Isn't that cute? Here's some of that textured shimmer paper with the eclectic paper behind it. And this is from the Charming Sentiments suite or bundle. And then this one I'll have on my blog on Monday. And I inked that paper with yellow and bubble bath and a little bit of Calypso. And then I just put those guys kind of overlapping with some gold foil. All right. So those are some bonus projects for you. But these are the three make and takes that I will send. If you want them, you'll need the bundle or use whatever you have in place. I won't be sending any stamped images. Okay, you guys, that's it. Thanks for joining me. I hope that I've inspired you. Like Karen said, there's not many ideas out there for this bundle yet, but I think maybe I have stoked the fire a little bit and get you guys to start using it and share what you make so that we all have some inspiration. All right, you guys, I'll see you next Friday, same time, 2 o'clock, with some Hey Chuck projects. He's a fun one. All right, guys, have a great weekend. Bye-bye.